disguise for me.
Thank you.
Well, I don't know how they do it because, man, it is hot in these ghillie suits. We got to keep it warm in there for the kittens as it is. And then they have to have a mask and then the ghillie suit on top of that. That is just crazy, crazy hot and such dedication. So thank you, everybody. I try to get out of this thing. Thank you, everybody, for joining us for feeding the kittens. Afton and Erin are going to be helping Jamie raise this litter of babies, and so she wanted to show them how these guys are used to eating. Kittens develop a, I doubt that you could hear much of what she was saying, but kittens develop a certain way of nursing with each individual person, and they get used to the way that person handles them. So it's a little bit difficult for them when they're getting handled by somebody different. So that's why it's a little bit awkward, even though they have been eating quite well. So again, I want to thank everybody who joined us on this live. I hope you share it. I hope you donated to help us take care of these cute little babies. The idea will be as soon as we can wean them onto meat that we will do so, because we want them on the bottle for as short a period of time as possible. And we want them to be where they're not handled so much, because they're going to go into, let me turn it around here. They're going to be going into our bobcat rehab area, which is behind all those trees over there. And those cages are, I think, 200 or 220 feet long and 20 feet wide. And they have cameras on them, so you guys will be able to watch them as they grow up and learn to hunt and learn to be bobcats and learn to stay away from people. And then we will find a great spot for them in the wild where they can be released. So I am so happy that you are joining on their journey, and we will talk to you guys later.